Hey guys, Hardik Patel here from eComHardy.com, and in this series of videos, I'm going to show you how to create a Shopify e-commerce website. Also in this video, I'm going to show you how to move the products from the WordPress existing website to Shopify itself. You will see the links for each tutorials in the description below. So feel free to check it out at any point if you want to skip this video and want to go to the next video. So let's get started. Now go to my website called eComHardy.com, and on the homepage itself, if you scroll down, you will find a lot of popular and useful tools here. But if you scroll down, you may find this banner says best alternative to WooCommerce. Simply click onto that banner. So if you click onto that, it will open the Shopify website where it will show up something like this or similar. You need to fill out the email address first. So let me fill out my email address and start trial. So it will ask you further questions to understand your status and your behavior, and it will suggest you accordingly more tools and apps to boost your business. So let's get started. It says which of this page describe you. You're just starting or you already selling online. In my case, selling online already, but if you are newbie or fresher, select this option, go next. And it says, are you currently selling on other platforms? Yes, I am selling on Amazon, eBay, I'm selling on WooCommerce, I'm selling on Etsy. So you can select whichever best or main platform you are selling onto, like eBay is your main business source. Then you just select eBay and then go next. Now, where would you like to sell? An online store, in person, existing website, social media, online marketplace, etc. So I would like to sell online marketplaces as well as on my online website as well. Also, I would like to sell on social media too. So I would select relevant options. If you have a shop, existing shop, where you want to, you have customers visiting to your shop, or if you have a pop-up shop or retail store, what do you plan to sell first? Digital products, dropshipping products, services, print-on-demand items, you select that. But if you don't know what you want to sell, or if you want to think about it and decide later, simply don't tick anything, just simply tick this one and decide later. But in my case, I simply select this one only for now and then go next. Where is your main business located? In my case, is Australia. In your case, could be United States, India, Afghanistan, anywhere. Okay, simply select the relevant option, Singapore, Malaysia, whatever, and then next. And it will ask you to choose the account if you already have signed up. If not, you can add the account or create the account. So I would like to tick add account instead of signing up. And then I would like to add the email ID and then password, and then login. It will ask for authentication code because I already have logged in to Shopify before and I already have authentication app set up. But in your case, it will not ask any authentication code because you are signing up for the first time. And once I do so, I simply welcome the best converting world. So it's building your store right now. So basically, it's building the draft store or default store. Now it is showing the backend right now. The name is My Store. If you have multiple stores, you can click here and it will show up all the stores you have. Here is the home page of the website. You can go through these things. So like you can import the products via CSV from existing website if you have already. If you are willing to import the products from WordPress WooCommerce website, check out the video I made already. Link is given in the description below, or maybe you can see the card pop up here. Check out that link as well. After you migrate your website, if you are making the fresh website, don't worry. Simply ignore this step. You can give a name to your website. So let me show you the website I want to copy for this tutorial. So this is the website called chickymickey.com. I want to copy this website, okay? So maybe I'll give the same name, Chickymickey. So name your store or name your website. Okay, phone number, you can add email address, you can add later, store email and all. I don't want to change anything for now. I just change the store name, that's it, and then save email address. I will leave it as it is. Also, for the legal purpose, you can add the ABN. If you are registered business, then you can add the taxation details here. Now, the plans, if you go to the plans here, it will show you the plan is under current trial, and then you can choose the plan as well. So you can choose if you are just selling via a retail store and you are not selling online, simply go to the retail plan or basic plan costing you only $7 per month after $1 subscription of first month. But if you're selling online as well as local, go through the basic plan in the beginning, and once your business grows, you can go to the higher plan in future. Now, let me go back. Maybe let me choose basic plan. Okay, so select basic plan, and it says until 8th March is $1, and on 7th April it will cost me $56. For now, I'll leave everything as it is. You can scroll down, you already gave the name, you can enter the email address and phone number for your store, you can sign up your store currency, you can change the location settings and also metrics and kilogram. Now let me go up and go to the billing part. You can enter all the billing details. I will go through these options one by one in my next tutorial videos, but for now I'll skip this part, so I'll just close this one for now. Customize your online store is the next step. So what I do is customize the theme. If you don't find this option here, you can always go to the online here under online store, under the sales channel themes. So here there is default theme Dawn chosen as a current theme, but what I can do is I can simply click on customize here and customize my default theme. Or if you want to change the theme to different theme, you can simply scroll down here and visit the theme store, and under here you will find all the paid and free themes available in the Shopify theme library. I will in the beginning go through the free themes only, and once I make enough money, I will decide to change my theme and I will go with the premium theme. But free theme itself would be okay to use and will serve the purpose. No one will know whether it's a free theme or premium theme. Only difference you will find is some of the features which might be missing compared to the premium theme, but those features you can always add by adding the apps, so that's fine for now. Now there are free about 12 themes here. You can go through one by one of any of these themes. So like just imagine Sans theme. I quickly open the Sans theme in next tab, and it will look like this. You can find out what features it includes as well. You can always check out the demo store. So click on to the demo and it will show like something like this one. You can always modify the theme, so don't worry. You can change the theme colors and sections and everything, so don't worry. So let's, for the sake of this tutorial, let's go and select Sans or Sensei, whatever theme name is. So let's select Sans theme and try theme. Now, once the theme has been added, you can always customize directly before you publish it, or you can publish it directly and then customize. But customizing first is more better option compared to publishing first, okay? By the way, if you want to have a look, how does it look like online? If you want to preview it, you can always click on these three dots of any themes you have installed and then click on to the preview. So you see here right now, by default, the theme it installed, which is Dawn theme, looks like this one. If you click on any products right now, the products are not available, so you can't see much. You can click on catalog as well, but everything is empty. Now, let me close these tabs for sake and simply click onto the customize. So I click onto the customize first. By the way, before customizing theme, it's better to add few products first. And once you have the products handy, it will be much more making sense for and you can customize the theme very easily. So I would keep it as it is for now. You can also customize any products, particular product page or cart page by going through here. Anyway, if you want to add the logo or something, you can always click onto the theme settings here and select the logo. If you don't have any logo, you can always upload from the desktop. Okay, and this is the PNG file. So if you have already a logo made, you can always upload directly. Or if you don't have any logo created yet, then you can use the tool called Canva. Okay. And in the Canva, you can create your own logo for free of cost. Now, once I uploaded the logo here, I can see how does it look like here. Now, the logo size is very small. I can always increase the size of the logo here. Okay. And you can make more changes. Now, this part is done. Now, in the next tutorial video, I'm going to show you how to upload the products and how to create the product using the Shopify dashboard here. So stay tuned. Let's go to the next video. Thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to subscribe this channel so you will be notified when I create and upload any future videos. And also please thumbs up to this video if you like this tutorial video. And don't forget to comment me in the comment box below if you have any questions or suggestions. Thanks for watching, guys. Stay tuned. Let's go to the next video.